Welcome to History Summaries. Ever pondered how ancient civilizations, bereft of the technology we are surrounded by today, managed to perform wonders that continue to dumbfound us? Such questions have long puzzled historians, scientists, and inquisitive minds. From the magnificent pyramids of Egypt to the enigmatic stone formations of Stonehenge, these ancient societies have bequeathed mysteries that persist to baffle. Despite being devoid of the technological progress we take pleasure in today, they managed to erect architectural wonders, formulate intricate calendars, and even chart the stars with astounding precision. Each of these accomplishments is a tribute to their inventiveness, tenacity, and comprehension of the world around them. Yet, about these societies remains veiled in mystery. How did they pull off these extraordinary accomplishments? What secrets are encrypted in their artifacts? And maybe most captivatingly, what became of these once prosperous societies? Today, in this video, we will be unraveling the mysteries of Khufu's seven enigmas of ancient civilizations. Our first stop takes us to Egypt, home of the pyramids of Giza. The ancient Egyptians carved a place in history with their monumental pyramids, a testament to their grandeur and an enigma to the modern world. These colossal structures erected on the Giza Plateau have stood the test of time, weathering centuries and captivating generations. Imagine, if you will, a time before cranes, bulldozers, or any modern machinery. A time when the only tools available were simple hammers, chisels, and perhaps a few rudimentary pulley systems. Now consider the construction of the pyramids. Each block, weighing an average of 2.5 tons, chiseled to precision and stacked meticulously to form these monumental structures. The level of precision and symmetry that the ancient Egyptians achieved is astounding, considering the rudimentary tools at their disposal. The Great Pyramid of Giza, the largest of the three, is a marvel of ancient engineering. Its base is almost perfectly square, with each side measuring about 230 meters. The precision is such that the difference between the longest and shortest side is less than 1%. This level of accuracy, achieved without the aid of modern technology, is a mystery that continues to baffle researchers and historians. Moreover, the alignment of the pyramids with the cardinal points is another feat that adds to their enigma. The Great Pyramid is aligned with true north with such accuracy that it deviates by only 3/60ths of a degree. How the ancient Egyptians achieved such precision in alignment without the help of a compass or any advanced astronomical tools is a question that remains unanswered. The pyramids of Giza are not just structures of stone, but monuments of mystery erected by a civilization that in many ways was far ahead of its time. Their construction techniques, their astronomical knowledge, their sheer determination all remain shrouded in mystery. As we delve deeper into the enigmas of ancient civilizations, we find that these structures offer more questions than answers. The pyramids of Giza continue to stand tall, their secrets safely guarded. Next, we find ourselves in England, gazing upon the enigmatic Stonehenge. Stonehenge, this mystifying circle of towering stones, stands proudly on Salisbury Plain, an emblem of prehistoric times. A marvel of human endeavor, it continues to baffle us with its existence. Its purpose and how it was constructed are enigmas that have intrigued scholars for centuries. Imagine, if you will, the sheer effort it took to transport these massive sarsen stones, some weighing as much as 50 tons, across vast distances. The smaller blue stones were also brought from afar, from the Preseli Hills in Wales, a staggering 150 miles away. Theories suggest a mixture of human strength, sledges, and boats were used, a remarkable feat in itself. Then there's the question of why Stonehenge was built. Was it a temple, a burial ground, an astronomical observatory, or perhaps all three? Some scholars believe it was a sacred meeting place, where people from all over gathered for important ceremonies. Others think it was an ancient calendar, with the stones carefully aligned to mark the movement of the sun and the changing seasons. Recent research has thrown up yet another theory. Stonehenge, it suggested, might have been a monument of unity built by people from different regions across Britain as a symbol of peace after a period of conflict. And then, there's the mystery of the henge itself. Why was the ditch and bank built outside the circle of stones, rather than inside as is common in other henges? It's yet another puzzle that adds to the enigma of Stonehenge. In the end, all we can say for certain is that Stonehenge was of immense importance to our ancestors. Its construction would have required not just physical effort, but also sophisticated knowledge of geometry, astronomy, and engineering, a testament to their ingenuity. Stonehenge, an enduring testament to our ancestors' ingenuity, keeps its secrets well. We now journey to the deserts of Peru, where the Nazca lines etch their mysteries into the earth. Imagine this, you're soaring high above the arid plains of southern Peru, and the world below you is a vast canvas of enigmatic etchings. These are the Nazca lines, a series of ancient geoglyphs that sprawl across 500 square kilometers of desert. They depict a variety of figures, from simple geometric shapes to intricate depictions of animals and humans. But who created them and why? The lines were etched into the desert floor over 1,000 years ago by the Nazca people, a civilization that flourished in the region between 200 BCE and 600 CE. But their purpose? That's been the subject of debate for decades. One theory suggests that these lines served as astronomical markers, aligning with celestial bodies to form a giant observatory. Others propose that they were part of a ritualistic water cult, their shapes corresponding to the flow of underground rivers. Some even suggest they were landing strips for ancient extraterrestrial visitors, though this idea is, understandably, met with a fair bit of skepticism. As for the method of their creation, it's believed that the Nazca people used simple tools to remove the reddish-brown iron oxide-coated pebbles that cover the surface of the Nazca Desert, revealing the light-colored earth underneath. It's a simple process, but the precision and scale of these lines suggest a level of planning and execution that is truly remarkable. Despite extensive study and numerous theories, the purpose of the Nazca lines remains an enigma. Were they pathways to the gods, a giant astronomical calendar, or something else entirely? We may never know for certain. The Nazca lines, a giant sketchbook of ancient times, remains an unsolved puzzle. Our next stop is China, where the Terracotta Army silently stands guard. In the heart of China, a life-size army of terracotta soldiers stands in formation, as if ready for battle. This army, discovered in the mid-20th century, is a testament to the grandeur of the first emperor of unified China, Qin Shi Huang. But the question that has puzzled historians and archaeologists alike is, why did Emperor Qin commission such an enormous army of clay? Emperor Qin was known for his obsession with immortality and the afterlife, and it's believed that he ordered the creation of this army to accompany him in his journey after death. Over 8,000 soldiers, each with unique facial features, along with chariots and horses, were meticulously crafted and arranged according to real military formation. Another intriguing aspect is how this colossal project was accomplished. The Terracotta Army was created over 2,000 years ago, during a time when technology was primitive. The precision, the attention to detail, and the sheer scale of the project is awe-inspiring. It's estimated that several hundred thousand workers toiled for nearly 40 years to complete this monumental task. The terracotta soldiers were made in sections, with the torso, head, arms, and legs crafted separately and then assembled. The soldiers were then placed in battle formation in three large pits, a silent, eternal army guarding their emperor. Yet despite the thousands of figures unearthed, there's still much that remains a mystery. For instance, what significance did the intricate detailing of each soldier hold? And why were they buried in such a secretive manner, their existence unknown until a chance discovery centuries later? The Terracotta Army serves as an eternal testament to an emperor's quest for immortality, a silent witness to the past, and a source of never-ending intrigue and speculation. As we delve deeper into the mysteries of ancient civilizations, we realize that each artifact, each monument, holds a story waiting to be discovered. The Terracotta Army, an eternal guard for an emperor, holds its secrets in its clay hands. Now we dive into the depths of the ocean in search of the lost city of Atlantis. This legendary metropolis, steeped in mystery and intrigue, has captivated the imaginations of scholars, explorers, and dreamers for centuries. A city of unparalleled wealth and technological advancement, said to have disappeared under the ocean waves in a single day and night of catastrophic events. But what is the truth behind Atlantis? Does it exist, or is it simply a myth? There are many theories about the location and existence of Atlantis. Some believe it to be located in the Mediterranean, near the Pillars of Hercules, as described by the ancient philosopher Plato. Others suggest it might be found near the Caribbean, citing underwater formations that resemble man-made structures. Some researchers argue that Atlantis was not a physical place, but a metaphorical representation of a highly advanced prehistoric civilization. They contend that the story of Atlantis is an allegorical tale meant to impart moral and philosophical lessons. Then there are the fringe theories. Some propose that Atlantis was an extraterrestrial colony, while others assert it was a technologically advanced civilization that had harnessed the power of crystals or even developed the ability to manipulate the weather. However, despite extensive search and research efforts, no definitive physical evidence of Atlantis has been found. The city remains elusive, hidden beneath the waves of speculation and conjecture. Much like the mythical city itself, the truth about Atlantis seems to slip away just as we reach out to grasp it. Yet the search continues. The allure of Atlantis, with its promise of undiscovered knowledge and lost wisdom, is too great to ignore. Scholars, explorers, and dreamers alike continue to seek answers, driven by the same human curiosity that has propelled us throughout history. Atlantis, a city lost in time and water, continues to elude us. But its legend lives on, a tantalizing enigma that continues to challenge our understanding of the past and spark our imagination about the possibilities of the future. Finally, we find ourselves on the remote Easter Island, home to the iconic Moai statues. This isolated place, seemingly lost in the vast Pacific Ocean, is the setting for a mystery that has puzzled historians for centuries. The island's unique landscape, untouched by modern civilization, has been shaped by the extraordinary efforts of the Rapa Nui people. On this tiny speck of land, far removed from the rest of the world, they created something spectacular, something that continues to awe and mesmerize us even today. The Moai statues, carved from the island's own compressed volcanic ash, are monumental symbols of Rapa Nui culture and history. Over 900 of these imposing figures dot the island, their remarkable forms standing tall against the windswept backdrop. Each statue is a marvel of craftsmanship. Their exaggerated features, particularly the oversized heads, carefully etched into the stone with an attention to detail that inspires awe. The largest of these, Paro, is a sight to behold, soaring at a staggering 33 feet and weighing an estimated 82 tons. The creation of these statues, especially considering the lack of modern machinery, represents a feat of human ingenuity that leaves us pondering. How did the Rapa Nui manage to carve, transport, and erect such immense sculptures? Scholars have proposed numerous theories, some suggesting that the statues were walked into place using a complex system of ropes and sledges. Others speculate that the Rapa Nui might have utilized a clever system of ramps and levers to move the statues. Yet, despite extensive research and archaeological studies, no definitive conclusions have been reached. The precise methodology remains shrouded in mystery, adding to the enigma of these captivating monoliths. However, what we do know is that the creation of the Moai was more than just a physical endeavor. These statues are believed to embody the spirits of the Rapa Nui's deceased ancestors. Their stoic faces, eternally watching over the island and its people, are a testament to the spiritual and social complexities of this intriguing civilization. Each Moai statue, a silent sentinel a time long past, is laden with tales of a society that thrived against all odds. As we gaze upon their weathered faces, we see not just stone figures, but reflections of human resilience and our relentless pursuit of understanding. The Moai of Easter Island continue to captivate, their existence a testament not just to the Rapa Nui civilization, but to the unyielding spirit of human perseverance. As we continue to unravel the mysteries of our past, we find ourselves humbled by the indomitable spirit of human ingenuity and our ceaseless quest to understand the enigmas of our past. And as we draw to a close, hope you found this journey into history as captivating as we did. If you enjoyed this video and would like to keep delving into the mysteries of our past with us, please hit the like button, subscribe to our channel, and tap the notification bell to ensure you don't miss any of our upcoming historical content. Your engagement and support make the creation of these educational videos possible. From all of us here, thank you for watching and being a part of our journey into the past. Our journey through time and across continents brings us back here, still filled with questions. We've traced the sands of time back to the pyramids of Giza, a testament to human ingenuity and an enigma that continues to baffle us. Who built them and how were they able to construct such monumental structures with such precision? Our journey then took us to the enigmatic Stonehenge, a circle of mysteries etched in stone. Its purpose and the people who erected it remain as elusive as the stones themselves. We then flew high above the Nazca Lines, a set of ancient geoglyphs that stretch across the Peruvian desert. Their purpose and the method of their creation continue to perplex researchers and enthusiasts alike. From the vast desert, we marched alongside the Terracotta Army, a silent and stoic battalion guarding the tomb of the first emperor of China. The sheer scale and detail of this underground army is a puzzle that continues to intrigue us. Our expedition then took a deep dive into the mythical lost city of Atlantis, a civilization said to have been swallowed by the sea. Its existence, location, and sudden disappearance remain shrouded in mystery, continuing to captivate our imaginations. Finally, we arrived at the remote Easter Island, home to the towering Moai statues. The how and why of their creation and transportation is an enigma that has left us in awe and wonder. In our exploration of these seven enigmas of ancient civilizations, we've seen that our past holds many mysteries. The enduring fascination these enigmas hold serves as a stark reminder of our insatiable curiosity and our relentless pursuit of the unknown. As we continue to unearth and explore, the mysteries of ancient civilizations remain, reminding us of our enduring quest for knowledge.